happy holidays. It's the end of 2017, and here are a few of my favorite things. Is that how it goes? I'm like second guessing the tones of it. You get the gist of it. So one of my favorite additions to the tested office this year was the universal laser cutter. I've used laser cutters before, but this one just blows my mind because you have a much better bed size than normal laser cutters or the ones I've used previously. And also it's really fast. I just wanted to show you a project that I did for my dad. Don't tell him about it. This is my Christmas present for him, but I don't think he watches YouTube. So we're on the safe side. We have this joke in my family that he's a disco turtle. I have no idea where it comes from. I think it comes from how he dances. I'm not sure, but I wanted to do like an artistic rendering of a turtle shell. And this is my attempt. So this is like laser cut acrylic. And then I just put in these patches of laser cut wood, and it's three layers. So you get a little keyhole. I just have masking tape on here now because I'm still painting the edge here. But yeah, it's just fun. Like there's so much fun you can do with laser cutters, and it goes beyond. I think what most people do is just like little cutouts of plywood and stuff like that. And that's really nice, but there's also like a lot of really cool things you can do with it. So I've been super excited about having access to it. I'm also really excited about that it has such a good filter because I love laser cutters, but boy, do they stink. Just like this video. Not true. My second favorite thing of 2017, it's something I've had for a few years now, actually. I don't think they're for sale in the States. So it's these two Swedish women who have designed an airbag bike helmet. It's called Hövding. And basically it just goes around and you like zip it up and then you turn it on by like plugging this thing in. And now if I would fall over or sneeze really hard, it would kind of explode like an airbag around my head. The thing is, I've had this for a couple of years. It has still not exploded. What do you say, deployed? It is still not deployed, so I'm not sure that it works, but it seems like it's working really well for other people and that it actually protects people better than a normal helmet, unless it is that some item is falling on you from the top. Like if somebody drops a piano in your head, this is not gonna do anything. But if you fall off your bike, it protects you really well. And I feel really comfortable wearing it. And I just think it's such a neat invention because nobody likes a bike helmet. Let's be honest, they're ugly. My third favorite thing I actually got just today. I got to borrow one of these a couple of months back, but they finally started shipping to their backers, and I just got my Shaper Origin. I'm so stoked about this. So it's a handheld CNC. I think we did a tested video of me using this before when I did a giant clothes hanger. It's like a handheld CNC. So the way it works is you get this tape and you tape it down on the material that you want to cut. And this one has like a bunch of cameras and this tape lets it know exactly how it's positioned. So you're just watching on the screen and it's kind of like directing you how to go and you're doing the movements, but then it's auto-correcting the router, I think up to an inch. So you can suck pretty bad and it still will like cut pristinely for you. And it's just really nice because you're not limited. I mean, you can CNC stuff, but you're also not limited to a bed size. You can do it on like weird objects. You can even do it on a wall. So it just opens up like a whole new world of possibilities. I'm super stoked about it. And I think it takes up dust fairly well. Like you just connect it to your shop vac and it won't get too dusty. I'd probably still not do it like in my home environment. So that's why I'm just gonna use it here at the tested office. So when I build projects, I use a lot of servo motors. And like my use case is a little bit niche where I don't care a lot about precision, but I care about the way that it looks. Like I really care about how a machine moves rather than what it does. And the method that works best for me is to do like a recorded sequence. So you move a machine around and you can kind of like, you're almost like doing robot puppeteering, and then you can replay that. And this is a servo motor controller from Servo City. You can plug in up to 4 servo motors, and then you just twist these knobs and like record however you want it to move, and then you can replay it. And this is like perfect for me, I feel like. It might not be the perfect product for a lot of people, but for me it is. It also has a really weird bug where I have to slam it for it to work in the beginning, but it works really reliably after you do that. So here's a motor, here's some batteries I just charged. Okay, so yeah, it's just super simple. You just plug it in and then you can move it around and then I can record a little sequence. So that's me recording, and I think this should be it replaying it. Ta-da! It's so good, and you can decide if you wanted to do it in a loop or only once. This is like, I don't know. This is the perfect product. This blew my mind and changed my shitty robot game. Those are my favorite things for 2017. Thank you so much for watching and happy holidays. Bye. Here are a few of my favorite things. You get the gist of it.